After 14 months, Senator Panfilo Lacson will resume his work at the Senate when session resumes on May 9. His comeback coincides with the start of the impeachment trial of Ombudsman Mercedes Gutierrez. Observers have counted Lacson as a vote for conviction of Gutierrez, having been identified as an ally of President Aquino. But Lacson says his vote is anybody's guess. There's also the raging debate on the reproductive health bill in Congress. Lacson expressed support for President Aquino in pushing for the responsible parenthood bill.
Obligasyon ko bilang pinuno na lumapit sa lahat ng sektor para kausapin at magpaliwanag sa kanila ng mahinahon. Kahit pa ang sabi ng iba, dapat i-excommunicate na ako. Pero sa huli, kailangan ko magdesisyon. Kailangan ko pa rin sundin ang aking konsensya. Kailangan kong gawin ang tama.
But supporters of the RH and RP bills face an uphill battle with strong opposition from the Catholic Church. Also at the Senate, Lacson plans to continue his anti-corruption campaign and bills for innocent people languishing in jail. How exactly will he pursue these advocacies and use his remaining 2 years at the chamber?
Welcome back to ANC Presents, the Nation Up Close. Still with us is Senator Panfilo Lacson. Welcome back, Senator. Before we go to the next topic, let's just finish the hanging issue about your travel papers. You were saying that, you know, they're authentic, but you just don't want to put in jeopardy, in hot water, whoever helped you do that.
Bigyan ka ng konting details, Lynda, if I may. No? Dumating yung consul, of course, pre-coordinated because I coordinated with a high official from the DFA here. No? And so, kinontak niya yung consul in that area. And then, so he came to the hotel where I was staying prior to my departure. And then, nilabas niya sa, galing doon sa maliit na portfolio niya, yung application form, of course, travel document. And he filled it up for me. Siya na nag-fill up. Ako na senator mag-fill up. Then, sabi ko, teka, kukunin ko yung aking photo, passport ID picture. Hindi na, meron na ako. Dinownload ko sa computer. So, naglabas siya ng dikit-dikit. Sabi ko, ito na lang kasi ito, nakat na. Hindi, may dala kong gunting. So he cut into four parts, Of course, one photograph per cut. So, teka, hiram tayo ng stapler. Hindi, meron akong paste dito. So dinikit niya na rin doon. And then, firmahan mo na lang. And then, nilabas niya yung kanyang pangtatak. Tapos pinirmahan niya, ayan na yung travel document mo. And then, I signed it.
So, para siyang mobile passport processing unit.
And sabi ko, ginagawa mo yun dahil sinadura ko sa kami itawag from. No, talagang ginagawa namin ito sa mga distressed OFWs. So, in effect, I felt like a distressed OFW.
Sige, I'll look forward to seeing the travel document. Meanwhile, sir, well, of course, May 9 is the start. The opening of the session is also the start of the impeachment trial of Ombudsman Mercedes Gutierrez. Bakit sinasabi mo na hindi ka shoe-in as a somebody who would vote to convict?
Yeah, but of course, because hindi ko pa nakita yung evidence. Wala pang presentation. It is yung burden ito ng prosecution team, ng House, to really make their case para makonvince yung mga senator judges to vote to convict. So,
pero sir, well, I don't want to put you on the spot naman din because I know, of course, that you will still be sitting there as a judge. Pero karamihan naman dito, sir, kasama to sa mga exposés ninyo noon, di ba? The articles of impeachment, a lot of it were exposed by you. It's probably based on some of the papers that you introduced in the Senate also.
But that's a different matter altogether because that pertains to the crime as committed. But itong impeachment is how Ombudsman Gutierrez handled those cases filed before her office. So magkaiba yung madaling isegregate yun hindi yun mapaghahalo.
So what are you looking for as far as the evidence against Ombudsman Gutierrez is concerned?
Well, dalawang articles betrayal at saka culpable Pag sinabing culpable, talagang deliberate yun. Medyo mahirap i-prove yun kung tutusin kasi kailangan talaga deliberate, intentional yung pag-violate. Kung hindi alam na nag-violate ng konstitusyon, hindi yun hindi ground for conviction. Mm-hmm. Of course, yung isa, yung betrayal of public trust. Mm-hmm. So siguro, medyo yung latitude ng mga senator judges, medyo malawak. Mm-hmm. But let's face it, this is a political exercise, ano? Although, having said that it's a political exercise, it's also an exercise between the senator judge and the people. Mm-hmm. Because they will be watching. If it's very obvious na ito, nagboto tong isang senador, maski sloppy yung presentation ng evidence, mm-hmm. Mukhang mananagot din siya sa mga constituents niya. Mm-hmm. So I think the senators will also look at that.
Mm-hmm. Before we leave the issue of yung exposés and the mga cases, ano nang mangyayari dun sa mga whistleblowers ninyo? One of them was... I can't say inadvertently kasi mm-hmm. hindi ko alam mm-hmm. kung bakit nasama si Mr. Barredo. Ano na ba ang mangyayari doon?
Unang-una, no, kumita ba si Mr. Barredo ng 50 million? Paano siya nasama sa plunder? I mm-hmm. don't think nakinabang siya doon kasi mm-hmm. of course runner siya, no. Mm-hmm. But then nagkusang loob siya pumunta sa Senado.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I remember that.
For a long time, tinulungan ko pa siya yung office ko, binigay ko ng accommodation sina Barredo and mm-hmm. and everybody and else, ano? Mm-hmm. Kaya nga nag-appeal din ako sa mga kasama ko senador. Siguro may obligasyon naman kami kay Barredo kasi mm-hmm. kaya naman siya siguro minalas mm-hmm. dahil do sa pag-appear niya rin before the Senate. Of course, mm-hmm. before kay ex-Senator Jun Magsaysay. Mm-hmm. And then nag-continue pa yan do sa sunod na Congress.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So in relation to that, ano I suppose you will still push for the whistleblowers
yeah,
act.
Yeah, the bill.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Together with that, what are the other measures that you will push? You already made a statement about the responsible parenthood bill. Yeah. Ano ba responsible parenthood o reproductive health?
Well, what's in the name, ano? Uh-oh. Yung contents naman ang mm-hmm. importante. Ano ba yung nandun sa bill itself mm-hmm. that should warrant the senators and the congressmen mm-hmm. to really push it or oppose it, mm-hmm. you know? So, I think there's a lot of disinformation going on, ano, mm-hmm. Yung Catholic Church, ano, I don't want to be at loggerheads with my own church because mm-hmm. I'm a Catholic and I also go to church to hear Mass. But sometimes, pag nagmimisya ako, after yung communion at sinabing the Mass is over, mm-hmm. talagang, kasi pipigilin ka pa eh, mayroon mm-hmm. pa mga public announcement. Pero yung public announcement na yun, napakahaba, mm-hmm. Sinisiraan yung mga advocates. So, mm-hmm. anong gagawin mo? Di siyempre, lalabas ka na. Anyway, tapos na naman yung misa. So, hilahin ko na yung miss ko, yung mga anak ko, alis na tayo kasi mm-hmm. ayoko na rin marinig yung sinasabi. Because disinformation, sana kung factual or totoo.
So, kayo mismo na-experience niyo yan? Because, you know, mm-hmm. meron ng nabalita at na-record mismo mm-hmm. na mga sinisiraan nga ng ilang mga pari, yung mga advocates, etc. Mm-hmm. But I have not talk to somebody who yeah. actually experienced this.
Although, hindi naman minenso kasi nandun lang sa isang sulok ng simbahan. Mm. Hindi naman siguro ako nakita nung pare. Ano? Pero hearing all those disinformation, mm-hmm. parang mataturn off ka rin. Why stay there pa? Anyway, mm-hmm. tapos na yung obligation mo as a Catholic, tapos na yung Mass, mm-hmm. and nakapagdasal ka na rin, nakapagpasalamat ka for whatever. Mm-hmm. So, bakit ka pa mag-stay to hear all those mga talagang ano eh, hindi. Maiinis
example,
ka rin pakinggan.
Example.
Well, they're always harping on abortion. Mm-mm. Maski pa ulit-ulit yung mga advocates, yung mga supporters, na abortion remains to be a criminal act, ano, mm-hmm. under this bill. Mm-hmm. It is condemnable, it is mm-hmm. illegal, it is criminal, and yet sila, tuloy-tuloy pa rin yung, mga evil, kasi ito, sila, gusto nila abortion. Mm-hmm. That's out and out disinformation.
Mm-mm-mm. What do you think are the chances of the reproductive health or responsible parenthood bill in the Senate?
Very limited yung headcount ko sa Senate. Dalawa pa lang yung nakausap ko. And one is against, one mm-hmm. is for, ano? Mm-hmm. And mm-hmm. the one who is for is may qualification pa because mm-hmm. he's concerned about the Catholic Church. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So, hindi enough sample mm-mm. kung survey ang pag-uusapan kasi dalawa lang yung nakausap ko. But the point is, since the president is advocating it, mm-mm. I think it is a very good chance of passing mm-mm. sa Senate at least.
Compared to before when the president was against it?
No president was against it. Mm-mm. But they didn't want to, to confront the Catholic Church on that issue.
Why do you think some of the lawmakers and some of the advocates are afraid to get into a confrontation or, as you said, be at loggerheads with the Catholic Church?
I don't know. Hindi ko makita yung point bakit just because the Catholic Church is...